This is a quadratic equation in one variable x. In order to solve this equation, we need to find that value of the variable x which satisfies this equation. That is, we need to find that value of x for which the left-hand side of the equation becomes equal to the right-hand side, which is 0. So how do we solve this equation? Well, one way is to solve it by hit and trial. But hit and trial is not a good method for solving this equation because it may take a lot of your time and effort to reach the correct solution. So we see that the left-hand side is a quadratic polynomial. It is an x square term, a term containing x, and a constant term. So it is a quadratic polynomial. We have learned how to factorize polynomials of this type. So let us factorize the left-hand side. Now we can factorize the left-hand side by splitting the middle term. That is, we need to find two numbers whose product is 2 and sum is negative 3. So we need to find two numbers such that their sum is negative 3 and product is 2. If we consider negative 1 and negative 2, their product is 2 and their sum is negative 3. So we can split this using these two numbers. So this implies x square minus x minus 2x plus 2 is equal to 0. Now, from the first two terms, take x common. So x into x minus 1. From these two terms, take negative 2 common. Negative 2 into x minus 1 equal to 0. So this is what we have. Now from this entire thing, we can take x minus 1 common. So take x minus 1 common. We have x here. So x minus 2 equal to 0. So this is what we get after factorizing the left hand side, x minus 1 into x minus 2. So the first step is done. We have factorized the left hand side. What should we do next? Now observe that this is something into something equal to 0. So we can represent it as P into Q equal to 0. So we represent it as P into Q equal to 0, where P and Q are two numbers. So this is P into Q equal to 0. Now when the product of two numbers is equal to 0, what can you say about the two numbers? Well, if the product of two numbers is 0, at least one of them will be 0. That is, if P and Q is equal to 0, either P will be 0 or Q will be 0 or both will be 0. That is, either one of them will be 0 or both of them will be 0 if the product of two numbers is 0. So we can use this in our equation as well. If we consider this to be P and consider this to be Q, we can say that either x minus 1 is equal to 0 or x minus 2 is equal to 0 because their product is 0. So one of them has to be 0 or both could be 0. That is, both x minus 1 and x minus 2 equal to 0. So this is what we have. Either x minus 1 equal to 0 or x minus 2 equal to 0 or both will be 0. Now these are simple linear equations, so we can solve them. X minus 1 equal to 0 means x equal to 1. So we have x equal to 1 or from this we have x equal to 2. From this we have or both x equal to 1 and x equal to 2. So this is what we have, x equal to 1 or x equal to 2 or both x equal to 1 and x equal to 2. But the variable x cannot be equal to 1 and 2 simultaneously. That is, the value of variable x cannot be both 1 and 2 at the same time. So we ignore this. So we are left with only this condition, that either x minus 1 equal to 0 or x minus 2 equal to 0, which gives us x equal to 1 or x equal to 2. So these are the two solutions of this equation. We can substitute this in the equation and verify. So substitute x equal to 1. We have left hand side as 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus 2, which is equal to 1 square is 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 minus 3 equal to 0, which is equal to right hand side. So this satisfies this equation. Now let us check for x equal to 2. So left hand side is x square, which is 2 square, minus 3 into x, which is 3 into 2 plus 2. This is equal to 4 minus 6 plus 2. 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0, which is equal to right hand side. So even 2 satisfies this equation. So x equal to 1 or x equal to 2 are the solutions of this equation. We have got these solutions by factorizing the left hand side and by using this rule that if the product of two numbers is 0, either of them will be 0. Now let us solve one more example. So as in the previous case, let us factorize the left hand side. So in the left hand side, we have x common. So let's take x common and write it as x into 2x minus 5 is equal to 18. This is what we get after factorizing the left hand side. So we write, this implies x is equal to 18. Or 2x minus 5 is equal to 18. From this, we get x is equal to 18. Or 2x minus 5 is equal to 18 gives us 2x is equal to 18 plus 5, which is 23. X is equal to 23 by 2. So 18 plus 5 is 23. 23 by 2 is the value of x. So this is what we have. But now, if you substitute these values in the original equation and check, you will find that none of these is the correct solution. So how did this happen? Where are we wrong? Well, we are wrong in this step. We cannot use this. The zero product rule, which we had learned, that if the product of two numbers is zero, either of them will be zero, holds only if we have zero on the right hand side. Why is it so? Because if the product of two numbers is zero, one of them has to be zero. But if the product of two numbers is any number other than zero, say 18, so if the product of two numbers is 18, it is not necessary that one of them will be 18. The two numbers could be 2 and 9, or the numbers could be 3 and 6. In fact, we could have many more possibilities. So we cannot say for sure that if the product of two numbers is 18, one of the numbers will be 18. So we cannot use this method. So how do we solve this equation? Well, it is very simple. Take this 18 to the left hand side. Now we have a 0 on the right hand side. Now let us try and factorize the left hand side. So in order to factorize the left hand side, we need to split negative 5x. So we need two numbers whose product is 2 into negative 18, which is equal to negative 36. We take 2 into negative 18, which is negative 36, and sum is negative 5. Now negative 36 is negative 9 into 4. Also, negative 5 is negative 9 plus 4. So negative 9 and 4 are the two required numbers. So let us split the middle term. We have 2x squared. We take negative 9. Negative 9x. We take 4 from here. Plus 4x. Minus 18 equal to 0. This is what we have. Now, from these two terms, what do we have in common? We have x common. So take x common, we have 2x minus 9 left. From these two terms, we have 2 common. So we take 2 common. Now 2 into 2x is 4x and 2 into 9 is 18. So this is what we have. Now, we have 2x minus 9 here, 2x minus 9 here. So we have 2x minus 9 into, we have x plus 2 equal to 0. So this is what we get after factorizing the left hand side. Now can you solve for x from here? Now we have this into this is equal to 0. So the product of these two is equal to 0. So either of them will be 0. So we can write that 2x minus 9 equal to 0 or x plus 2 equal to 0. Because the product of these two is 0, so one of them has to be 0. So we have 2x minus 9 equal to 0 or x plus 2 equal to 0. And now we can solve for x from here. If 2x minus 9 equal to 0, x is equal to 9 by 2. Because 2x is equal to 9, x is equal to 9 by 2. So x is equal to 9 by 2. Or if x plus 2 is equal to 0, x equal to negative 2. So this is what we have. X is equal to 9 by 2 or x is equal to negative 2. This is the solution of the given equation. You can put these values, that is 9 by 2 or negative 2, in this equation and verify that these values will actually satisfy this equation. Now let us solve one more example. Root 2x square minus 7x plus 6 root 2 is equal to 0. Now don't be scared of these root signs, that is these square root terms. We need to follow the same steps as we had done earlier. So we have everything on the left hand side and only a 0 on the right hand side. So let us factorize the left hand side using the same rule. Take the product of these two, that is the coefficient of x square, which is root 2, and the constant term, which is 6 root 2. We get root 2 into root 2 is 2, 2 into 6 is 12, and we have negative 7 here. So we need to split this term, that is negative 7x, in order to split it, we need to find two numbers whose product is 12 and sum is negative 7. So, if we have two numbers, that is negative 4 and negative 3, their product is 12 and the sum of these two numbers is negative 7. So 12 is equal to negative 4 into negative 3. Negative 7 is negative 4 plus negative 3. So we can split negative 7x using these two numbers. So this implies root 2x squared minus 4x minus 3x plus 6 root 2 equal to 0. This is what we have. Now, from these two terms, we take root 2 x common. So we are left with x minus 2 root 2. Because root 2x into x is root 2x square. Root 2x into 2 root 2 is 4x. So this is what we have. Next, consider these two terms. From here, take negative 3 common. So we are left with x minus 2 root 2. And we have a 0 on the RHS. So this is what we have. Now, this x minus 2 root 2 is common. So we take x minus 2 root 2 common. And we are left with root 2x. Root 2x minus 3. Now note that x is not inside the root. X is outside the root. Only 2 is inside the root. And now we can easily solve it. The product of these two is 0. So one of them has to be 0. So we can write that either this is 0 or this is 0. So we have x minus 2 root 2 equal to 0 or root 2x minus 3 is 0. Because only then their product will be 0. And we can solve it as x is equal to 2 root 2 or x is equal to 3 by root 2. So this is what we have. X is equal to 2 root 2 or x is equal to 3 by root 2. This is the solution of this equation. So we can solve a quadratic equation by taking all the terms on the left hand side, then factorizing the left hand side to get it in the form of something into something equal to 0. Equate each component to 0 and solve for the variable. This is how we can solve a quadratic equation by factoring.